Good morning, Pastor Ben. Welcome for today's lesson. Today is Tuesday. We are going to look at another new topic. The topic is known as geometry. Geometry is a very wide topic, actually a very important topic, but for today, we are going to specifically look at this subtopic or the concept of finding the surface area of different cylinders. So we are looking at the surface area of the cylinders. Before we discuss about these cylinders, I want to let you know that there are three types of cylinders. So we are going to look at the types of cylinders. We are going to look at the type of cylinders, and I have said that there are three types of cylinder. The first one is known as the cylinder closely on both sides. The first is the cylinder closely on both sides. Number two, we have the cylinder closely on one side. We have the cylinder closely on one side, and the third and lastly, we have the cylinder open on both sides. The cylinder open on both sides. Now, how does a cylinder look like? We have to look at how does a cylinder look like. A cylinder is something of this kind. A cylinder is a figure of this kind of a shape. And now, if you look at this shape, this is a combination of shapes. In this one here, we have the first part, we can call this one number one, we may call this one number two, and we may call this one number three. So, in this case, the first part, this one is a circle. This is a circle, it's a circular shape. This one we call it curved surface, actually, and also this one here is also a cycle. What I'm trying to insist is that you may be having such a kind of a book. This is a bit rectangular in shape, but if you fold it like this, then you obtain a curved surface. So this is the curved surface number two, which we are talking about. But now, if you look at this, this part here is circular in shape, and also down here is also circular in shape, and that's why we have two cycles, whereby we have number one and number three here. So this is an example of a cylinder. So we have said that we have three types of cylinders, whereby we have the first one is a cylinder which is closely on both sides, and number two, we have a cylinder closely on one side, and number three, we have a cylinder which is openly on both sides. Why I've decided to teach you this is because this subtopic is very important. We have sent you several exams to do, and you have done them. And if you try to go through what we have sent you, you may realize that each and every exam that we give you, there is a question which involves a cylinder. So, in another word, I am saying that there is no day that you sit for an exam, you miss a question of this kind, especially class 7 candidates. So I am insisting that this topic is very important, and you have to pay paid much attention in order for you to grasp something. Now we are beginning with number one, which is the cylinder closity on both sides. We are looking at the cylinder closity on both sides. This question involves formula. And remember, in our previous lessons, I told you that you don't know the formula, then you may not be able to answer the questions. But also another important thing is that knowing the formula is one thing, and using the formula is also another different thing. That is to say that you have to know the formula first, but after having known the formula, then you must know how to use it. So I'm going to give you a formula of finding out the surface area of a cylinder closely on both sides, actually a formula which has been simplified, where we say that surface area is equal to 2 pi r into bracket r plus h. Surface area is equal to 2 pi r into bracket r plus h. This is the formula of finding the surface area of a cylinder which has been closely on both sides. Example. Example of a cylinder which has been closed to both sides. So here we say that this part has been closed, and this one here has been closed. So when we are finding the surface area of a cylinder, they can either give you the radius or they may give you the diameter. So in this case, this part here, actually from this point here up to this point here, this one is known as diameter. Diameter is not new to you because we have met it when we were dealing with the areas of different shapes, particularly the circles, and also finding the circumference. So when I talk about the diameter, or when I talk about the radius is a half of the diameter. How we obtain diameter? Diameter is equal to 2 times r. And how we obtain radius? Radius is equal to diameter divided by 2. So what I'm trying to say, that these things are not new to you because you have already met it. But now, when we are dealing with the cylinder, we have the diameter or radius, and also we have the height. The height is from this point up to this one. That is the length of the curved surface. So now in this case, I have said that they may give you here the diameter, or they may give you the radius. Assume that this is now the diameter which we have given here as 28 centimeters, and the height here is 30 centimeters. So we are required to find the surface area of this figure. How do we get the surface area of this figure? We have said that surface area is equal to 2 pi r into bracket r plus h. Now, if you look here, we have been given the diameter, and here we have the radius. In order for us to use this formula, then we have to say that the radius is equal to d over 2. That is to say that we have to divide the diameter by 2 in order for us to obtain the radius. Therefore, radius will be 28 over 2. Here 1, here 14. So our radius is 14 centimeters. Now we have to write our formula here, whereby we have said surface area is equal to 2 pi r into bracket r plus h. Now surface area is equal to 2 times pi. I want to remind you, pi. Pi may be 22 over 7. Pi, this is pi. Pi, you may be given 3.14. Pi, you may be given 3.1 over 7. All these are pi. This one has been written in as a mixed fraction. If you change this into proper fraction, it will take you this, because 7 times 3, 21. 21 plus 1, then you get 22 over 7. You come back to this. This one here has been written in decimal. Now, what I want to insist is that, unless you are told, when you meet a question of this kind, check at the diameter. When the diameter is exactly divisible by 7, then use 22 over 7. When the diameter is not divisible by 7, use 3.14. Diameter or radius. So in our case there, the diameter is 28 centimeters, which is exactly divisible by 7. But after dividing to look for the radius, we have 14 centimeters, which is also divisible by 7. So now we proceed by saying that the surface area is equal to 2 times 22 over 7 times r, which is our 14, into bracket 14 plus h, which is 30. Close the bracket. From this point, we simplify. What we simplify with it? You look at where we have the common factors. So, 7 here 1, 7 here 2. In this case, we multiply now. 2 times 22, 44. 44 times 2, 88. So, surface area is equal to 88. Times we add this. If you add this, we are going to get 44. Then finally, we have 88 times 44. Then we multiply. If you multiply this, 8 times 4, we get 32. Write 2, carry 3. 8 times 4, 32. 32 plus 3, 35. So here we have 35. 8 times 2 again, 32. Carry again 3. 8 times 4, 32. 32 plus 3, 35. 35. Then from there, we add, we get 2, 7, 8, 3. Then finally, surface area is equals to 3872 centimeter square. This is the answer for this question when you are finding the surface area of a cylinder which has been closely on both sides, and that's how we can work it out. Square unit is very important. Square unit is very important because you forget about the square units when you find the area, then you will be wrong. That is one. Number two. Here we are looking at number one, which is a cylinder which has been closely on both sides. Then now let us look for a cylinder which has been closed one side. Cylinder closed on one side. Cylinder closed on one side. There are different terms that they may use to give you explanation or to call this. It is not necessary that they have tell you that the cylinder is closely on both sides. They may tell you finding the surface area of a sealed tank. So if they say find the surface area of a sealed tank, they are telling you to find the surface area of a cylinder which has been closely on both sides. Find the surface area of a log, the same. Now, when we are dealing with the surface area of a cylinder which has been closely on one side, they may tell you find the surface area of an opening tank. So an open tank, meaning that one part of the tank is open, so you will be required to find the surface area of this formula. Formula, surface area is equals to I R into bracket R plus 2H. Close the bracket. Friends, you have to differentiate these two formulas. I mean, when you are finding the surface area of a cylinder closely on both sides, and also when you are finding the surface area of a cylinder which has been open one side. I shall use the same units so as to make emphasis. Closely on one side, so from the drawing and even in exam, they may tell you find the surface area of the figure below. From the drawing, you look at this one, it has been closed on one side. So even if they have not told you whether it is closely or not closely, then you simply know that this figure has been closely on one side, and you will be required to use this formula. Therefore, surface area is equal to 22 over 7 times, remember what we did by looking for R is equal to D over 2, therefore R is equal to 8 over 2, here 1, here 14. So our radius is 14, so we are going to take 14 times 14 by R, 14 into bracket, 14 into bracket, 14 by R into bracket, R plus 2 times 3. Having said and done, here 1, here we have 2. Remember, this one is 14. So to obtain the area of the cylinder which has been open on one side, so obtaining the surface area of a cylinder which has been open on one side, we say that surface area is equal to 22 over 7 times 14 into bracket 14 plus 14 plus 14 plus 2 times that. Therefore, here 1, here 2, we are going to have surface area is equal to 44. Here we multiply 2 times 3, 30, we get 60. Now 60 plus 14, we get 74. So here is times 74. Therefore, surface area is equal to 44 times 74. Multiply 60, carry 1. 16, 17. Here, multiply there, you are going to have 8, 28, carry 1. Here we are going to have 28 plus 2. Here 28 carry 2. Here we are going to have 28 plus 2. We are going to have 30. Then we add again 6, 5, 2, 3. Then the surface area is equals to 3,256 centimeters square. So this is how we can obtain the surface area of a cylinder which has been closely on both sides. How said that it is very important. As I said, it's very important for you to understand this. Today, we have looked at the cylinder velocity on both sides. We have also looked at the cylinder velocity on one side. Come in the next lesson, we shall be looking at the cylinder opening on one side. And another name for this cylinder opening one side is also, we can also tell you to find the surface area of a pipe. However, from here, I want to give you some work to do. What I'll give you to do is go through the papers that we gave you, all the exams we have given you. There are questions which involve the cylinder, particularly cylinder closed on both sides and also cylinder opening on one side. Try to do those questions. I want to wish you all the best. And I believe that we shall meet in the next lesson to complete this part which has been remaining. And we shall continue with other geometry questions. Thank you very much. Welcome for the next lesson.